Warning, you are infected. You have 14 Trojans and 8 rootkits? Oh no! Only $29.99 to unlock the removal tool and remove this malware. Okay. Phew, that was close.
Hey Trish?
Yeah?
The bank is on the phone. Did you just buy a car in Italy?
And welcome to DIY in 5. My name's Trisha Hirschberger, and today we are talking all about malware. What the heck is it? Now, I studied Latin in school, and let me just tell you that anything that starts with mal is bad. But more on that later. In today's episode, we'll go over some of the best tips for keeping your computer malware-free. If you find this video useful, make sure to subscribe so that you don't miss out on any future tech tips. So what is malware anyway? Malware is short for malicious software, and its primary purpose is to cause harm to your system in a whole variety of different ways. You can think of it kind of like the flu, but for your phone or PC. The symptoms will range quite a bit, but its overall job is to disable, damage, or take control of parts of your system. Malware usually seeks to make money off you somehow. It could be stealing your data, spying on your activity, or hijacking core computer functions. It's a real pain in the ass. Some signs that you may be infected with malware include, but are certainly not limited to, a suddenly slowed system, a bunch of annoying ads that were definitely not there before, crashes or freezes, or the terrifying blue screen of death on Windows, new toolbars or plugins on homepage settings in your browser, or a completely borked antivirus software. Sometimes you might even be unlucky enough to get hit with ransomware, which will tell you to your face that it has your data and would like you to pay a ransom to return your files. Viruses, worms, Trojans, botnets, rootkits, spyware, and crypto miners are just some of the types of malware out there. Sounds fun, right? Nope. So what's the proverbial flu shot? How can you prevent malware attacks from happening? Step one, be vigilant. You've probably heard not to open shady attachments in emails or download software from third-party sites, and this is great advice. Always download from a trusted site and pay attention to the permissions and extra add-on downloads. Don't click on questionable links. Anything with a funny ending other than .com, .biz, etc., or from an unknown source could be dangerous. Make sure that your software and operating system is patched and up to date as often as possible. Step two. Arm yourself with protective tools. Firewalls, antivirus software, and anti-malware software are a few examples of tools that can help you remain malware-free. These programs usually help by either scanning and removing anything questionable on your system, blocking infection in real time, or both. As an added bonus, you'll want to find something easy to install that has a low impact on your device. Something that slows you down in an effort to help speed you up is like that friend who comes over to help you get work done and then convinces you to play video games instead. Some popular options of protective software out there include Avast, Malwarebytes, AVG, and tons more. Avast antivirus and anti-malware has a pretty comprehensive suite of protection features completely free, and offers some bonus features like auto app updates, extra ransomware protection, and advanced firewall features for a monthly subscription. Avast will both scan and remove malware, as well as offer real-time protection against attacks with low impact on your PC's performance. Another popular free software is Malwarebytes. The free version will scan and clean an infected device, and the premium version for $39.99 a year does that plus real-time prevention. It has features for Windows, Android, Mac, and Chromebook. AVG antivirus is another option that offers free basic services like stopping malware, blocking malicious links and emails, and the ability to scan your PC. The full version, for an unlimited number of devices, might I add, also includes enhanced firewall, secure online banking and shopping, and includes a special antivirus pro for Android. Finally, if you don't want to get third-party software, both Mac OS and Windows have gotten hip to the punch and now include more sophisticated security built right into the operating system. Mac OS Mojave will auto-update, encrypt your data with File Vault 2, prevent malware from changing critical system files, and more. Windows 10 also offers auto system updates, Windows Defender antivirus built-in, and real-time and ransomware protection. Well, that's that. What type of protective software are you running? Or do you live life on the edge and fly without? I always wanted a shirt that said, "I'm so badass I eject without safely removing hardware," but honestly, I follow all the rules. like 100% lawful alignment when it comes to tech. Anywho, I hope your computer is in tip-top shape, and if you have any questions not answered in this video, please leave them in the comments and we'll do our best to answer them. My name's Trisha Hirschberger, and you have been watching DIY in 5.